Eric Forkel is the second seed and a past PBA national champion. And Justin Hromek is our tournament leader and just won one away from his first singles title. That's our outstanding field of finalists for today's Professional Bowlers Tour telecast. Yes, Bowl One is the scene. 15 miles from downtown Detroit, we're in Troy, Michigan, for the $250,000 finals of the United States Open. You couldn't get another person inside. It's jam-packed here, and we're glad. Hello again. I'm Chris Schenkel. 29 titles in our field of five. More about each of them a little bit later, but I want to say this for my colleague. He won the United States Open in 1978. He's here. His name is Nelson Burton, Jr., Bo.
Well, thank you, Chris Schenkel. I am excited. It's a great tournament and a little history. Before 1958 and the PBA was formed, the winner of this tournament was considered the world's champion. Then in 1971, this became a Triple Crown event on the PBA Tour, and that did not diminish its importance. It's a tough tournament, grueling, 7 days, 56 games. The five people in the finals today are the toughest. They've all made championship round appearances in 1994. Eric Forkel, Brian Voss, have won major titles. However, our tournament leader is bowling's best-kept secret. Justin Hromek has a 15 caches in a row on the PBA Tour, the most of any player. He's won at the junior level, the college level, and he's trying to bring it up to the top of the line. He's trying to win his first tournament, a major here today. He's going to be tough, Chris.
Okay, and this is the prize money that's being split. The winner's share today of the United States Open is $46,000, second $24,000. Third, it'll be $14,000, fourth, $10,500, and fifth, $8,500. So, we're ready for that first match. Head-to-head, Parker Bohn and Jess Stayrook. Jess pulling out of Tempe, Arizona. Parker Bohn from Jackson, New Jersey. The statistics on Parker, 30 year older. 10 national titles. So he has left the 2-4-7 bow on the left lane.
Parker, an excellent spare shooter. The 2-4-7, though, is one you really have to watch out for a left-hander. It's the left side of the lane's breaking quite a bit more today than we've seen all week long. He has to guard against chopping that 2 off the 4-7. Opening shot.
Nicely done, and with a lot of confidence. This left-hander going against under lefty Jess Stayrook, grew up, lived for a long time in the San Diego area. He was the tournament leader at the Tums Classic and finished second, 13th telecast in his career.
The Rock, a physical player, five-step delivery, just muscles the ball all the way through the shot, gets a very short backswing, comes down, and watch the loft over the line, no slide. Chris, he wears tennis shoes while he's bowling.
Okay. Leaving the 4-7. On the left lane.
Projecting the ball to the left is the key for Jess Stayrook. He doesn't get this out as wide. He gets out to about the fifth board, has no chance of remaining in the 1-2 pocket, crosses almost all the way across the head pin. Jess, as you see, seven rounds, 56 games, as opposed to a normal 42-game tournament. Jess kills the shot, throws much harder at left-hand corner spares.
Jess Stayrook. Three titles to his credit, showing his appreciation of the huge crown. And now with spare working, Parker Bohn III on the right lane. Four, seven.
Demanding lane condition today. No pull area for the players, as you see the style of Parker Bohn, just about ideal. Cocks that head, locks that wrist at the top, drives down through the swing area, hits that line with his foot perpendicular to the foul line. Good shot.
Second spare for Parker, whose last win was in Phoenix in 1993 when he won 173,000.
Parker Bohn playing what we call an extreme outside line this week. He's standing to the extreme left. He'll slide in this area. His target is projected between the first and second arrows.
Still no strike in bowl one lanes.
That's been the history of this championship pair as Parker gives it a little timeout. He whips it out there and trusts the ball, and it just hangs. For the major titles, especially the U.S. Open, Chris, they have made the lane conditions very demanding.
Mm-hmm.
Spares are important. You cannot miss spares. If you get on a roll, you can throw a bunch of strikes, but fill those frames.
56-game format. And Bo, at one time, the All-Star, 100 games.
The All-Star, which is the forerunner of the U.S. Open, was 100 games at one time. One year, 1966, it was 115 games. Here's the tennis shoes. Now, these are regular tennis shoes. The first man I ever saw use those were my brother, who used one on his right pivot step, and he won the Masters with that.
Seven ten on the right lane.
Stayrook keeps the ball in the pocket, swings it wide. The second pin on the left-hand part of your screen, the four, doesn't quite get enough bite on it, does not take out the seven. Once again, good spare-making technique by Jess Stayrook. He flattens the wrist, increases the ball speeds, and just throws a rocket towards the left corner.
As Bo indicated, Jess uses non-bowling shoes on tour. Here's his explanation.
Well, I had a lot of problems with the approaches, and from week to week and at home, I was having just tremendous problem with getting good footing all the time and good traction. So I started wearing tennis shoes when I practiced and became real comfortable, and I've been using them ever since. And as far as the rule goes, if I don't leave any marks on the approach, it's okay.
On May 29th, ABC's coverage of the Indy 500 will include Parnelli Jones leading the field of 33 behind the wheel of the awesome Mustang Cobra. Well, Ford allowed me to drive this 5-liter V8 base car yesterday, and I'm spoiled. This irresistible machine is rigged for two onboard ABC cameras, so watch my two favorites, the 500 and the Mustang. It can go and move.
Before Daddy gets up.
Ooh,
pretty. And no more of these are Daddy's corn pops.
Oh, look, Daddy's bowl is too full.
The problem with a cereal that tastes like popcorn, only sweeter, is that it disappears like popcorn, only faster.
Mommy, that's Daddy.
Who's there?
Hi, girls.
Happy birthday.
Now let's all go making breakfast.
Kellogg's corn pops. It's hard to stop when it's pops.
If you demand more from an aftershave than alcohol burn, you gotta try alcohol-free sensitive with Cooling Sensates. It's proof aftershave doesn't have to hurt to work. Take the heat out of aftershave. Demand proof. Try alcohol-free sensitive from Old Spice.
Start a project with Minwax Wood Finish and turn new into treasured, secondhand into first rate, ordinary into extraordinary. Because Minwax Wood Finish makes it easy to turn any project into a beautiful masterpiece. Minwax makes wood beautiful.
We're back again at Bowl 1 after that face card test. Troy, Michigan, and we have our first match underway. Close. Four pins separating Jess Stayrook and this man, Parker Bohn III. Another seven.
Well, Parker makes his best effort towards the pocket on that shot. The lane conditioner oil is 41 feet down the lane, and you'll see the break of this ball. It goes down about 41 feet, tries to make the right turn, doesn't quite have enough surface to flip back and take out the seven.
Touring pro Parker Bohn III still has some strong ties to amateur bowling.
Well, I'm going to drive 13 hours back home and bowl the New Jersey State Tournament with a bunch of my friends and buddies that I grew up with back at home. We bowl singles, doubles, and team event at Caroler Lanes at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Wants it all, and right now he's looking for his first strike.
Frustrating. Frustrating.
Well, starting to get that little perspiration on his brow. As you see the angle, he's playing that critical outside line, and the left-hand lane has just got him completely confused. He went high in the first frame and hasn't even been close here in the third and fifth frames. He needs to get the ball to the right of the head pin, drive the head into the seven.
Can you believe that? The seven dancing off the deck.
Well, he gets a break as the pins kick out of the pit. Now, a pin can come back into play. A ball cannot. A pin becomes active when it comes back into play. If a ball would happen to bounce back out of the lane, it is a dead ball. So Parker has nine out, only 79 through the fifth frame. Stayrook, 20-pin lead, can make it 30, has a strike working.
This in the fifth frame, the 3-6-7. What do we do here?
Well, it's not time to punt. But what he needs to do is get the ball to the right of the two pin, have the three pin, have the three slide over into the seven. This is the way to do it. Get right over here, slide the three right into the seven. If he can convert it, he will maintain his 20-pin lead. If he misses, it'll drop down to single digit.
Back-to-back open frames, one by each.
A lesson to be learned here by these players, and they know it. One-game matches for the U.S. Open title is very difficult just looking at the scoreboard. And when you have a real low-scoring environment and the lanes are erratic, it's important to reduce the amount of hook. Cover the fewest amount of boards gives you the best chance. Now, Stayrook playing a pretty good-sized hook. He's going to be in this position, and he'll be a much bigger hook than Parker Bohn.
There it is, third strike for Jess Stayrook. Confidence builder, if there ever was one. John Laspina over his left shoulder there on the right.
Strong part about Parker Bohn's game is he knows he can what we call square up and line that ball down into the pocket. And the lower you get with your shoulders and back over your knees, the less you have to squeeze the ball. And that's what he'll try to do here, get real low and drive it in there.
Still no strike in this first game for Parker Bohn.
But that's what he has to do. Parker Bohn made an excellent shot there. You don't need a bunch of strikes when 170, 180 may win the opening game. Don't get any open frames and hope you can get to the 10th and throw one in the clutch.
All right. Long a mecca of bowling. This entire Detroit area, including the state of Michigan, of course. There it is, coming in the seventh frame. Touring pros Bob Vespy and Glenn Blakely. Well, they took another kind of tour yesterday while I was driving the Mustang. They were at the Henry Ford Museum. Here they admire an Indy Pace car circa 1952, along with other vintage cars.
Spitfire earned a United States patent. Spitfire doesn't look like any other spark plug. And the patented Spitfire doesn't work like any other spark plug.
5 extra horsepower by merely installing these plugs. Quicker in the quarter mile. A 4.8% gain in mileage.
There's nothing like a Spitfire. You'll get more power and more mileage. Or your money back. Get the guaranteed Spitfire advantage at leading automotive stores from coast to coast.
Men are back.
Shake it.
No dandruff. You've got Selsun Power. Brush it. No flakes. You've got Selsun Power with Selsun Blue. Doctors recommend it number one over all leading brands. Dandruff problem? No way. You've got Selsun Power.
Join basketball's court jesters, the Harlem Globetrotters, as they hang with Mr. Cooper, Mark Curry at Walt Disney World. Next on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
This is Goal 1 in Troy, Michigan. The finals of the United States Open. Jess Stayrook here in our first game. Had a comfortable lead earlier. Now it's 6 pins. He can increase it to 16. Strike up, shooting in the 7th frame. His opponent, Parker Bohn III. Triple Crown champion, U.S. Open winner twice, Pete Weber. Here he is.
Yeah, I'm here with Brian Voss. Well, Brian, you've been plagued with the second place finishes lately. What are you going to do about it?
Well, today I'm going to blow up the pins with my X36 disintegrator. And if that doesn't work, I'm going to kick some butt.
There you have it.
See why I like to be around him? Great guys, Brian Voss, Pete Weber.
Likeable Jess Stayrook gets away with one. He makes the most of his 7th frame shot, getting a double, opening a 16-pin lead. Then he crosses to the right side of the head pin, gets an easy spare to shoot at. The 5-pin conversion here will give him a 15-pin lead through 8 frames. However, Parker Bohn lurking with a strike up in the 7th.
Okay, tonight on ABC, Rhea Perlman, Katie Nelligan, and John Hurd star in the world premiere of Spoils of War, followed by The Commish. All tonight here on ABC.
Parker could cut the lead of Jess Stayrook down to just 5 pins with a strike here, 8th frame.
Strike till the 7th frame, this 30-year-old from New Jersey, but now has doubled and is trailing by only 5. He can take the lead here in the 9th frame.
Put it on the rock. Jess, a determined young man, wants to really secure his position in the General Tire Tournament of Champions in 2 weeks with a victory here. Has a full, strong grip. He's a powerful man. He's an ex-carpenter, and he has to lean on all that power right here to get back in the match.
Four, six, ten.
One of the absolute fundamentals of the sport of pro bowling is becoming a truism here, as Jess Stayrook, on a difficult, demanding lane condition, is playing too much hook. And you see the pin action as the pins drive through the center, all the pins on the left chopping around the 4-pin.
A man who has won the Brunswick World, he's won in Seattle. Won 2 of 3 titles from the top seed, the other from number 2.
Once again, in a low-scoring environment, the straighter player has the larger margin of error. It's easier to be more accurate, and that's been the difference in the match so far. However, Stayrook has to power up, has an outside chance if he can throw a double here in the 10th frame. He has won a potential 190. That would force Parker Bohn III to mark to take the first match.
Sneak a peek. Yeah!
Just crossing too many boards today for Jess Stayrook. He throws the big hook. Parker has made the adjustment in the middle of the game, changing balls, threw it harder and straighter. And the first match is going to go to Parker Bohn III, which will set up a tremendous match against Brian Voss.
Can't get any closer. 179 for a disappointed Jess Stayrook, but wait.
Seven pins on the first ball. Parker will advance.
He did it the right way with a powerful strike. Well, I visit Parker's final score. It's 179 for the fifth place finisher, Jess Stayrook. This ABC Sports presentation of Professional Bowlers Tour will continue after these messages.
America's greatest horse race, the Kentucky Derby, May 7th on ABC.
When traffic congestion increases, unburned fuel and acids threaten to shorten the life of your car's engine. That's why today's Quaker State has engineered intelligent oil. Oil that senses the changing threats in your engine and adapts its own molecular structure for continuous protection. So whenever the driving conditions change, so does Quaker State. The intelligent oil for longer engine life.
With Minwax polyurethane, you can do more than admire your wood. You can live with it, too, because Minwax contains pure urethane oil to protect wood while giving it beauty you can really live with. Minwax keeps wood beautiful.
I don't need some fancy cologne to tell me I'm a man. I use Skin Bracer. It smells great, but it also cools and tones my skin. Confidence is very sexy, don't you think?
Skin Bracer Aftershave.
By Menon.
Okay, two scoops of raisins make Kellogg's Raisin Bran taste so good, people forget it's good for you. What do you think?
It's delicious.
And?
It tastes good.
That's the same reason.
He stole my answer.
And it's not an answer.
I agree with them. It tastes great.
Okay. You got the first part right. Kellogg's Raisin Bran tastes good, but...
good for us!
There are two reasons to eat Kellogg's Raisin Bran. The taste.
And?
Monday, the most dangerous job in the Navy.
We're SEAL Team. We're here to get you out.
And they wouldn't have it any other way.
I'm in position.
But this mission could be their last. Charlie Sheen and Terminator's Michael Biehn. Monday on ABC, Navy SEALs, parental discretion advised.
It's back. It's better. It's the third annual Great American Ford Sales Event at your Quality Plus Ford dealer. With a great deal on America's number one truck. Drive an F-150 for just $229 per month. The lowest payment of the year. Now with a driver's side airbag standard. See your Quality Plus Ford dealer and test drive the all-new Windstar. And receive 12 movie rentals from Blockbuster Video. See your local newspaper for all details. Hurry, your Quality Plus Ford dealer's Great American Sales Event ends soon.
Hi, I'm Marcel.
And I'm Frank.
We started the Lilac City Tournament 26 years ago.
And we plan to pay over $1 million in the 94 Lilac.
There's great team events for men, women, and mixed.
And the Lilac has doubles and singles events.
So bowl in Rochester, New York, at the Lilac.
With 18 great events, any bowler with a league average can win in the Lilac.
Call 1-800-36-LILAC for all the details.
Bowl in Rochester. You could be one of our big winners in the Lilac City Tournament.
Dennis Owens has the scores and more tonight on 27 News.
The Pro Bowlers Tour, brought to you by Kellogg's. With good taste, nutrition, and value, the best to you each morning from Kellogg's. General Tire, for over 75 years, General Tire's been making quality tires that you and your family can depend on. And Coast Deodorant Soap, that crisp, invigorating scent makes Coast the eye-opener.
Yeah. Here at the finals of the United States Open, an enthusiastic crowd, six strikes, all of them in a row. Parker Bohn III defeats Jess Stayrook, 219 to 179, and in steps, bowling out of Atlanta, Brian Voss. There's a part of the crowd. And there are the two combatants.
interesting pin action, Chris, as he cuts right through the middle, almost breaks up the split. And sometimes you get a great break and the pins push out those back pins. Not happening for Parker on that particular shot. He has the 410, will extend to the extreme right, slide that ball just around the four pin, hopefully into the 10. Okay.
Well, first frame open. Parker Bohn III, if you just joined us, won the first game 219 to 179. Here's a man, third straight appearance on our ABC telecast. Second last week at the Splitfire Spark Plug Open, fourth at Tums. That little customary hop at the line.
A man whose main weapon is his natural ability and his physical strength, just everything in perfect position. Look at this. Now watch how he comes straight through with that pivot step, steady head directly to the target underneath. Perfect form, gets the perfect result. Now he nailed that right hand lane in practice. This left hand lane is going to be the key for Brian. He's a good tough lane condition bowler. He's always done well in long formats, always done well in low scoring environments because he has the strength to keep the ball online and he's very patient.
Okay, 52nd television appearance for Brian Voss. Player of the Year in 88. 30th television appearance for Parker Bohn III. 10 titles, Voss has 13.
Keep it around the pocket, you'll will pay dividends today. Open frames are going to be very punitive today, as you see Parker hit a little bit light. We've seen this hit three or four times from him, not quite popping out the seven.
Parker had a fourth at the Johnny Petraglia Open and a third in Las Vegas. Pinfall of practice shot by Justin Hromek, tournament leader. Next up will be Eric Forkel to meet the winner of this game. Your philosophy, okay, Bo, stay near the pocket and eventually it'll work.
Well, that's it, Chris. Just to reiterate, it's very important to cut down the hook when it's very difficult to throw strikes. The grip of Brian Voss. The full grip extends that index finger, keeps his hand directly underneath the ball in the center of the palm, and good wrist action.
4-7.
Pinch soft, otherwise a very good shot.
When Brian makes our telecast,
drifts a little high, breaks up the 4-7-10. He's quickly up on the approach with another ball to cross over and shoot the spare.
Very good. Tomorrow here on ABC, there's twice the excitement on ice. First, beginning live at 1 Eastern, 12 noon Central and Pacific, it's NHL action. With regional matchups, including LA at Chicago or a battle in the Big Apple as the Islanders host the Rangers. Some of you will see Dallas meet St. Louis or Boston takes on Philadelphia, then figure skating follows. The country's best, including Brian Boitano, Scott Davis, and Nicole Bobic. Lane Bobic, take the ice. All right. On the Hershey's Kisses Pro-Am Figure Skating Championships, that's all tomorrow here on ABC Sports.
Brian Voss has an outside chance of making this. It's kind of a tricky shot, the 2-4-8-10. He needs to throw a great big hook and get it over in the 2-4 zone. The 2-pin will bounce back in here. The 4 will interfere and bounce into the 10. We've seen it made one time in the 20 years I've done this show. Tough shot.
Brian Voss against Parker Bohn III. You know, the Henry Ford Museum in nearby Dearborn is a place where children can get involved in the mechanics of an assembly line, an innovation perfected by Henry Ford.
Said, all men are great you'll do the big things later. You hit the snooze bar, you hit the snooze bar, you hit the snooze bar, you hit the shower. You start soaping up with Coast. Coast is rock and fuel for the senses. Coast is a big bold blast up that turns you back into a human dynamo. Coast, the eye-opener.
Continental Tires, in a torture test. Advanced technology in high-performance tires. Conti Sport Contact. Continental General Tires. Quality tire manufacturer and sponsor of the PBA.
Bowling's big guns head north of the border trying to bring home the Canadian bacon. It's the IOF Foresters Bowling for Miracles Open next Saturday on ABC Sports.
Yes, next Saturday at 3 Eastern, 2 Central, Club 300 Ball in Toronto, IOF Foresters Bowling for Miracles Open. The defending champion, Pete Weber, are on the approach interviewer today.
Parker Bohn III up in the fourth frame, 5-pin lead, can make it 15, strike work. All flat bellies out there, Chris, today. The five players in top physical condition, that grueling 56 games, 7 days. Usually the players who hold the line or throw a straighter ball prevail in the long tournaments because of the variety of conditions over 7 days.
Okay, now here's a young man that wasn't even born when we started this television series, Pete Weber.
Thanks, Chris. Eric, you're the straightest player on the show today. What have you done this week to keep up with the big strike balls that the guys are throwing today?
Well, I'll tell you, Pete, I thought I made a lot of really good shots this week, and I think when the conditions are a little on the tougher side, I think it's much better to be a little straighter, and I think that's really my game, and looks like it so far today. That could be a good thing to do.
And he's ready.
Okay, Pete, thanks. Eric.
Another 7-pin by Parker Bohn. A quick history lesson. In the 40-some years that I've kind of watched the U.S. Open in the long major tournaments, Chris, the straighter player usually prevails, the Carters, the Webers, the Anthonys, because they can adjust over a seven-day period.
You could fall in that category, too, couldn't you?
Oh, I hook it way too much for these guys.
Oh, get out. He's up.
All right, let's take a look at the line of Brian Voss. He'll be on the right-hand lane setting the ball in this zone. He'll be right around the first area. It's real soft, trying to play the gutter shot, get an extreme angle on the pocket.
Body English didn't help. 4-pin standing.
Gets the wall shot. The head pin goes to the sideboard. You see the 2, 4, 5, 7, 8 standing temporarily. The head pin does most of the damage, eliminating all but the 4-pin.
Okay. When Brian Voss is on television, his wife, Andrea, in the Atlanta area, invites the neighbors in for a cookout.
Voss taking a couple of different lines to the pocket. And once again, we'll see it from a different angle. He'll drift slightly to his left. He'll slide almost on the center lane or the 20th board. We'll see his trajectory right around the first arrow. Drift, swing. Here we go. Closing in on the pocket. Using a reactive resin bowling ball, his ball sliding a little bit too much in the conditioner of the lane, and it doesn't quite bite in the last 19 feet of dry as we see on the back lane. But he's not hurting himself as long as he doesn't get too far behind Parker Bohn. Right now, the difference is 5 pins.
Winner of the 1988 PBA National. His first victory ever was here in the Greater Detroit Open. Brian Voss, now Parker Bohn. Frame strike for Parker Bohn, the third in our second match of the afternoon. And we look at money leaders with Norm Duke finishing, made some money this week, but down the list, Johnny Petraglia, Walter Ray Williams, Brian Goble, and Steve Hoskins. And average leaders.
227, Walter didn't, he cashed this week. Norm was right there this week. Amleto, Parker Bohn right there in fourth place. And a national champion, the man who won the first Jewel of Bowling's Triple Crown, Dave Traber,
round out the top five. Now, Bohn can take a 15-pin lead if he can strike in the seventh.
Welcome to those pins. Parker Bohn leads by 15. Second game, we'll be back. United States Open.
All right, Chief. Open wide. Come on. Look, Daddy loves corn pops, see? And here he comes.
The problem with a cereal that tastes like popcorn, only sweeter, is that it disappears like popcorn, only faster.
Now finish? Good boy.
He may want seconds.
Kellogg's Corn Pops. It's hard to stop when it's pops.
Bowling is some people's idea of fun. Now, truck bowling, that's when things can get real interesting. But to do it right, you gotta have one of these. A 1994 Ford Ranger 4x4. Complete with push-button four-wheel drive, a whopping 4-liter V6, and a wide, powerful stance. Get a Ford Ranger 4x4 and go truck bowling. Come on. I just love league nights.
It's the final showdown of the regular season. The Rangers, Kings, Bruins, and Blues all take the ice in regional coverage. Sunday here on ABC.
There's a talented professional from Andover, Kansas, Justin Hromek, our tournament leader.
Waiting to see who he will bowl in about 35 minutes right now. One of the greatest in the game today, Brian Voss, new Hall of Famer, has to pull it all together. He trails by 15.
So it's a 10-pin for Brian Voss. Eric Forkel stays loose off to our right.
A game is constructed of 10 frames. Voss creeping up on the pocket. Is getting close. He has three frames left with which to close the gap over Parker Bohn. A
while ago, you saw a stat, Norm Duke, the money leader. This week, he finished 38th, 1380. And Leto Monticelli, 28th, Chris Warren, 30th. We'll give you the top 24 after a bit. Walter Ray Williams and Jim Johnson tied for 46th.
For Brian Voss, this is the key lane. He'll finish here in the 10th frame where he'll have a chance to close the gap. Let's see if he's zeroed. Overreaction. He had the ball breaking a little too much in the early going. Now he's straightened it out, which fundamentally he should do, and he can't quite get the correct break point as the ball just slides by the head pin, leaves an easy spare of the two, but he needs to get his strike percentage up if he's going to win this match.
Okay.
Parker could have really squeezed Brian with that particular strike. He hits a light, drives the 5-pin over towards the 10. The head pin intercepts it. Has a fairly simple spare conversion. He'll lead by 16, two frames left.
Oh, yes, coming up next on the East Coast and later today on the West Coast, ABC's Wide World of Sports. The Harlem Globetrotters bring their magic to Walt Disney World, plus the rim-rattling excitement of the Foot Locker Slam Fest final and the next major prep race on the road, the Kentucky Derby, the Santa Anita Derby, all today on ABC. The Globetrotters. In the night's frame.
What that strike and the setup does for Parker Bohn, it forces Brian Voss to get a double somewhere here, either in the ninth or the tenth, to have a chance against Parker. Three strikes would be better. However, two are almost mandatory. Here we go.
Hey! man that earned over $115,000 four consecutive years, over the million-dollar mark.
This is going to be an interesting shot. Voss, never even close on this left-hand lane, needs a strike to stay in contention for the U.S. Open. Has to take all his experience here and go with a Sunday ball. Here we go. I think he did the correct thing, Chris, but he kind of fanned on it. He went to the right, picked up the speed, but he kind of fanned on the shot, went high, left the 6-10. Is trouble for Brian Voss.
Grew up in Alaska, then North Dakota. Spent time in the Army, ending his Army career in 1981, and on to bowling. Brian Voss.
Parker Bohn needs 8 pins on 2 balls to secure this match. That's a winner.
Well, he did it. 180 for Voss. Will have Parker Bohn score for you later. This week, the Choice Hotels Tip of the Week features Bo Burton with some help from the son of Hall of Famers Don and Paula Parker.
ABC Sports presents a winning never gets old bowling tip brought to you by Quality, Comfort, Clarion, and Sleep Hotels.
Wow, what a terrific shot. John, you converted that 310 baby split. That ball deflected right over there. What weight is that ball?
A 12-pounder.
A 12-pounder. It sure helps to make those splits like that. If I was using my 16-pound ball, however, I would have to just nip the outside edge of the 3-pin to get that 16-pound ball to deflect into the 10. Now with John's shot, you can see him with the lighter ball hitting almost solid on the 3-pin. He has more margin of error. The ball deflects over in the 10. Now the seniors can all learn a lesson from this youngster. With a lighter ball, you get increased speed, more accuracy, and better percentage of making your splits. Remember, winning never gets old.
Look for future ABC Sports winning never gets old bowling tips brought to you by Quality, Comfort, Clarion, and Sleep Hotels.
You know, I'm always teaching bowlers how to put fingers into the shot, not just the ball. But you can also use your fingers to save money. If you're 50 or over, just call 1-800-4-CHOICE and you can save 30% at Choice Hotels like Quality, Comfort, Clarion, and Sleep. 30%. Now that's what I call aiming for the pocket.
Travelers 50 and over save 30% at Quality, Comfort, Clarion, and Sleep Hotels.
Here's the choice. Thompson's now or rebuild later. Thompson's now or repair later. Thompson's now or replace later. Over time, water invisibly weakens unprotected surfaces. Suddenly, you've got damage. Used regularly, Thompson's Water Seal Waterproofer helps stop costly damage. Keep up your protection. Maintain your investment with Thompson's now. Also protect with Thompson's Stain, the only stain with Thompson's Water Seal Waterproofer.
You're about to see the power of subliminal advertising.
Now, can you name bowling's hookingest and bashingest ball? It's the Rhino Pro Line, now featuring the reactive two-piece gold formulation that improves any game, only at your local pro shop.
Fresh fruit salad, yogurt. Okay, what vegetables do you have?
French fries, home fried, and mash.
Do you have anything that's good for me?
How about Tums?
If I don't eat your food, I don't need the Tums.
But you do. Tums has calcium.
Do these? No. They have aluminum and magnesium. Of these, only Tums helps knock out heartburn.
Ow! And gives you calcium.
Something my body needs anyway. What the heck? Give me the burger with everything, including the Tums.
Calcium-rich Tums.
Thank you.
here at the United States Open Finals. Four strikes for a 192 to 180 victory for Parker Bohn over Brian Voss. In this huge audience are a couple of guys you can't help but like. PBA Hall of Famers, U.S. Open champions, Mark Roth and Johnny Petraglia. There they are.
And Chris, 240 men went to the starting gate. 96 were league players, 144 touring players. The touring players out-averaged the league players by a little more than 10 pins this year. And let's see some of the other finishers. All of them pros. Phil Ringener, Ryan Himmler made a late charge. Mike Miller. Mazo has a lot of local following. Dave D'Intremont, qualifying leader. Wayne Webb and Jack Furyk. Moser, a pair of 300s this week. Part of the Kansas connection there in 14th. Bob Learn. Benoit, another one of those Kansas boys. Fields will be going to his first Tournament of Champions. Robert Lawrence, a former winner. Tim Chris, improving every week. Kelly Kaufman, another Kansas boy. Dickinson, go back to the senior store and start stealing money. And here's where we go next week, Chris.
Okay, next week we're in Markham, Ontario, near the great city of Toronto for the IOF Foresters Bowling for Miracles Open. That's a $210,000 event, and look at that. For $325,000 total, General Tires Tournament of Champions, April 23rd. 14th stop on a tour of 14 cities. Here we go. Third game for Parker Bohn III and Eric Forkel of Chatsworth, California.
A couple players with golden arm swings down that left side. Their shoulders are squared up, in line with target, left hip in line with target, and real good ball action.
Another 7-pin.
Keep it in play. Mm-hmm. He has done that very well the first two games and let his opponent defeat themselves.
Now in his second 1994 appearance, fifth in the PBA National, seventh tournament since recovering from a slashed foot he suffered in the devastating Northridge earthquake of January 17th. He's got to have some luck this year.
Well, he just kind of shreds the rack on that one. Excellent form here. The one trouble that Eric has every once in a while is has his backswing pop out at the top of the swing. On this particular shot, he comes straight through. When he's playing that outside line, he has less tendency to pull the ball across his body. What he needs to do, and he knows he has to, is stay with his arm swing inside out and a good knee, deep knee bend. He started with a strike.
A seven.
Doing a little research on the winners of the major tournaments and U.S. Opens, I found one other thing besides the straighter players winning, Chris, that players with more than 14 revolutions on the ball were often erratic and couldn't control the lanes for 7 days, and players with less than 10 didn't have enough power. So historically, the players between 10 and 14 revs have won the big ones.
So this is sort of a carry back to another stat you gave me a while ago about the number of strikes needed per year in the earlier days in order to be successful.
We used to say, Chris, in the mid-60s, if you could average four and a half strikes a game year-round, you could make a living on the Pro Bowlers Tour. That is not true today. I would say it's more like 5.5 now.
That's just what this man is averaging, though. Six in the first game, four in the second, and now it's his first of his third match.
Well, that falls right in with the form, Chris. When I say 20, 25 years ago, you could also make the All-American first team with a 205 average. Today, you can't get out of the rabbit squad with a 205 average. You better be up about 218. Now, let's take a look at Parker Bohn on the left-hand lane, playing the extreme outside line. My finger doesn't play it as well as his ball, but let's watch the action. Chris, do you think he was following my finger on that shot? Drew the wrong line for that boy. Right through the center, he could have opened up a 10-pin lead, and now with a conversion of just the 6-10, he'll just go for two. Just get the ball over in the 6-10 zone. Go for two pins.
Go for Parker Bohn in an afternoon of games where opens are not uncommon. It's one for him in the third.
Eric Forkel, the style very similar to Parker Bohn's, but even straighter. The full grip tucks both his index finger and his ring finger next to the ball, keeps it right on line.
6'10 for Eric Forkel. He is 33 years old, two titles, won the 92 National Championship.
You see Eric Forkel playing that critical outside line about the fifth board, a little soft with that shot, not quite the knee bend. And here's where the advantage of not throwing the big hook comes in. He gets away with a 6'10 spare, a big hook. He might have had the 4'6", 7'10. Eric, who flew in a coach for his major championship here, Len Mal, who has been his mentor over the years, also one of the top coaches for Dave Davis, a good friend of mine who is a top southpaw who's won many world championships. Now, we'll see the most extreme outside line of any of the players. Now, let's draw a pretty straight line. He'll throw a strike now. Follow that line right outside. Good straight arm swing. Here we go.
The left-hander.
A little upset with his ball reaction. Leaves the bucket, the 3, 5, 6, and 9. What he needs to do is get the ball right here between the 3 and 5, hopefully carry the ball and the pins back into the 9. Tough shot, carry out the 9 and still avoid the chop. If he converts, he will continue to lead in the match.
In the background and back at the Henry Ford Museum we go as we catch two hungry bowlers, very hungry. Bob Vespi and Lynn Blakely looking for an eatery. They've stumbled onto a 1940s diner. Get this, the original menu and a warm atmosphere.
He doesn't like power breakfast. He'll take a pass on poetry. Deep down, he's a grown-up Boy Scout. Way grown. He likes feeling clean and cool and very male. And he knows how to get there. Where have you guys been? Brute by Fabergé. Men are back.
I know it's a kid's cereal, but I love Kellogg's Frosted Flakes. This is my story.
I used to go to secluded places so no one would discover me. I knew it was wrong, but I just couldn't help myself. That's when it happened.
Hey, what's going on in there?
Luckily, he understood.
How can I condemn a man for something I do myself?
You've got to admit, Frosted Flakes have the taste adults have grown to love. They're great.
Join basketball's Court Jesters, the Harlem Globetrotters, as they hang with Mr. Cooper, Mark Curry at Walt Disney World. Next on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
We welcome the 1961 All-Star Champion, Bill Tucker. What a great guy. William Tucker. Sunnybrook Lanes, pro shop owner.
Bowled on the same team with my dad back in St. Louis in the late 50s and early 60s. Set the bowling world on back a little bit when he won. Nobody knew him at that time.
Four pin for Parker Bohn III.
Missed so far, he came out with an easy spare. Parker, with this conversion in the fourth, would lead by 5 pins over a man who is very similar to him in style, former national champion Eric Forkel.
Next week, Markham, Ontario. Oh, first now, here's Pete Weber.
Chris, Justin, 15 straight cashes in a row. What are you doing coming into your own like this?
It's not much that I learned what to do. It's more that I learned what not to do. And as far as the match play, my roommate Rick Steelsmith gave me a few ideas about how to view match play.
There you have it. He's ready.
Okay. It's the man that's a defending champion, Mark of Ontario, Canada.
I think that was an excellent statement made by Hromek. It's not what to do, it's what not to do out here on the tour. Most players defeat themselves. Now, here comes Forkel. He knows what to do.
'92, a big year for Eric. He won at Erie, PBA National Championship.
He's hitting that right-hand lane very well. In the fifth frame, he just shredded the rack. Right now, he needs to make an adjustment on the left-hand lane. That's going to be the key lane for him because that's where he's finishing if it comes down to a 10th-frame shot. Now, he's been erratic. What he needs to do is get the ball a little bit more on a tighter line around the second arrow and not so far out near the gutter. Get a tremendous angle of attack when he comes out that far. It's approximately 18 boards from the edge board into the 1-2 pocket. And that time, Forkel took advantage of all of them. Now he's put a little pressure on Parker Bohn, who hasn't trailed very often today.
Third game. Leaving a 6-pin. In the match, we'll take the winner of the final against Justin Hromek. For $46,000 to the winner.
Every player on the tour makes an improvement somewhere in his career to step up to the level of Parker Bohn. With him, it was wrist action for more revs on the ball. Little tape in the thumb hole for Eric Forkel. Very important to keep the good feel in the thumb. You don't want to squeeze the ball, especially for the big money.
Powerful indeed. We're at the United States Open, the semifinal match. More following this.
I can't go out there. The pollen kind of be worse. I need this job. My eyes are itchy. I'm stuffed up. I'm desperate.
With a leading allergy brand, you'll still be stuffed up. But with new DayQuil, you won't. New Vicks DayQuil Allergy. More medicines for more complete relief than the leading brand.
What a day.
New DayQuil Allergy. The anytime stuffy nose, sneezing, runny nose, itchy, watery eyes, so you can face the allergy season medicine. And new Children's DayQuil Allergy.
I went from probably 300 miles on a full tank to almost 400.
America is talking about Splitfire.
I'm probably getting, I would say, about 20 miles more per tank full, and that's a lot for me.
And when you're driving a four-wheel drive vehicle, you need all the extra gas mileage you can get.
I have them on my motorcycle, my boat, and my car.
I love them.
Splitfire. At $5.99, it only costs more till you use it. Monday, the information superhighway could take you anywhere. But who would have thought it could take you here? Have we made a wrong turn? Forrest Sawyer, day one, Monday.
Okay, in from Akron, Ohio, the commissioner of the PBA. Smile, Mike Connor. There it is.
Okay, been very entertaining matches so far, and this one is just as good as the early ones. Forkel has a lead over Brian Parker Bohn. He can make it 15 with a third strike.
Leaving a 6-pin on the right lane.
Eric felt that he didn't really belong here on the PBA Tour until he won the national championship in 1992, and that's given him the confidence to really go on to bigger and better things. His best year, he had $109,000 in winnings a couple years back, and he's always been a consistent player.
It has been announced that the United States Open will again be contested right here at this establishment in Detroit, Michigan. Bowl one.
man who knows how to win this tournament, 1964 U.S. Open champion Bob Strampy, down here and enjoying the action last night, and he picked Eric Forkel to be the winner. So far, Forkel has fulfilled the promise, but he's got three frames left to go in the semifinal.
And, Bo, in the earlier years, Bob Strampy used to fill in for Billy Wehler with me, and a true gentleman, great bowler.
Yes, he is. And as you see, Eric Forkel would pick it up a little bit. He's going to trip the three into the 6-10. He gets the first high-hit strike of the day. Now it's up to Parker Bohn to answer. He needs a strike to retake the leads, getting late, eighth frame.
Next week, the Pro Bowlers Tour continues northward all the way to Canada. It's the AIOF Foresters Bowling for Miracles Open next Saturday right here on ABC.
The best four shots of Parker Bohn today. The fifth frame, he throws an excellent shot. The sixth frame, the solid six on the right-hand lane, follows it up with two additional strikes. Now he's put himself in a position to squeeze Eric Forkel as he, using all his cognitive abilities to try to get through the last two frames and go on to the final. Here we go. The Bohn man, going for a 16-pin lead, just shreds the rack here in the ninth. Got to step to the plate, Eric Forkel, right now. Big shot. What an inappropriate time to get a wrap. The first really solid wrap of the day. Forkel could have stayed right in contention with the match. Now he has his back to the wall. Has to convert this 7-pin, throw a couple of strikes in the 10th to put some pressure on his opponent, Parker Bohn III.
This will be a hard-earned victory for the U.S. Open champion this year. Concentration a must today.
Yes, it is, Chris, and this man has done it very well all week long. I watched him bowl as he crossed a couple of pairs to the left of me in the qualifier, never lost his composure, but right now he has to reach back for a couple of strikes to force Parker Bohn to fill the 10th frame. Sweet shot there. He's done half of what he must do to give himself a chance. Now he has to replicate that shot somehow and knock them all down. That would put some pressure on Parker Bohn.
Coming on strongly here at the end of our semifinal match, the winner will go into the final.
Big time 10th frame for Eric Forkel. Regardless of what happens in this match, he collected his thoughts after a very disappointing 9th frame where he could have taken the lead and forced Bohn to strike in the 10th. Now he's forced at least Parker Bohn to mark, which has been no gimme today.
Finishing with a 202, three in a row at the end.
Parker needs a decent count and a mark of any type. A strike will secure a victory and let him go on to meet Justin Hromek. A good solid count and a spare. Anything less, we could have a tie or Eric Forkel could win. Finishing with four in a row as he did in his first match, a very strong finish. Parker Bohn's put himself in a position, just three pins necessary to go on to meet Justin Hromek. That's enough. Here we go.
There it is. Six in a row in the other game, and come on strong here to go into the finals. This ABC Sports presentation of the Professional Bowlers Tour will continue after these messages.
Oh, hey, Joe.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, Bob.
How's it going, man?
How's it going, man?
Great. Game's almost on. Got any Bud Light?
Hurry, I'm fresh out.
Fresh out. Fresh out.
Well, I'm out of here.
Hide the Bud Light. Joe's coming over. Hide the Bud Light.
Big Mouth, if you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Come on, where'd you hide the Bud Light?
It's in the garage. In the garage.
Okay, two scoops of raisins make Kellogg's Raisin Bran taste so good, people forget it's good for you. What do you think?
It's delicious.
And?
It tastes good.
That's the same reason.
He stole my answer.
And it's not an answer.
I agree with them. It tastes great.
Okay. You got the first part right. Kellogg's Raisin Bran tastes good, but...
Good for us!
There are two reasons to eat Kellogg's Raisin Bran. The taste.
And...
Sunday, Matthew Modine, Harry Connick Jr., and Eric Stoltz.
That's the crew of the Memphis Belle, huh?
It was their last mission.
We gotta die.
And it was do or die. The network television premiere of Memphis Belle, Sunday here on ABC.
Bowling in the USA.
Bowling in the USA.
For a great time this week, join your friends at one of these fun-filled bowling centers.
It's back. It's better. It's the third annual Great American Ford Sales Event at your Quality Plus Ford dealer with a great deal on America's number one truck. Drive an F-150 for just $229 per month, the lowest payment of the year. Now with a driver's side airbag standard. See your Quality Plus Ford dealer and test drive the all-new Windstar and receive 12 movie rentals from Blockbuster Video. See your local newspaper for all details. Hurry, your Quality Plus Ford dealer's Great American Sales Event ends soon.
Is your lover obsessed with you on the next morning?
I'm Julie Moran reporting from Santa Anita Park. We'll return to bowling in just a moment. But coming up at 4:30 Eastern and Pacific on ABC's Wide World of Sports, live coverage of the Santa Anita Derby from right here in Arcadia, California, where the best West Coast three-year-olds will meet in a major prep race leading to the Kentucky Derby. Plus, the Harlem Globetrotters bring their magic to Walt Disney World. And the rim-rattling excitement of the finals at the Foot Locker Slam Fest. It's all today here on Wide World. Now let's go back to bowling.
Now, this is the way it's happened in the first three games. Parker Bohn III has won them all. With eight strikes in the third match, he defeats Eric Forkel 228-202. And now it's Justin Hromek for the United States Open Championship. Round one coming up. First frame. Tremendously talented young bowler.
And very popular, Chris. Personable young man. Everybody likes him. And he's flat learned how to do it out here. Yet he does not have a victory yet.
Wobbly 10.
Awfully sweet shot to start a match. And nothing has really gone right for Justin in championship round matches. He's only averaged in the 170s, three singles performances. In all honesty, he was very sick in his last performance at the Quaker State, where he bowled a very poor 155.
Okay. Andover, Kansas, from New Jersey, Parker Bohn. He had eight strikes in the last victory. 4 in his second win, 6 in his first victories, defeating Jess Stayrook, Brian Voss, Eric Forkel.
Interestingly enough, Chris, he has not had a double in the first 7 frames of any of the matches and still has won 3 in a row. Let's see if he gets off to a quick start for the championship.
Gene, his mom, and Mary, his wife, are jumping with joy back home.
That's his first double in the first 7 frames of any of the matches. He's put it on Justin Hromek, who adds a piece of tape to his ball. Justin has 1 victory, a doubles victory, with Dick Weber as his partner. Ironically, I don't know if it's so much ironically, defeated Dick, me, and Bob Benoit. Justin with a very strong game, 5-step delivery, has an ideal arm swing, gets it up in good position, don't want to get it too high. He's going to drive right down through the explosion point, and look at the good wrist action with the elbow going directly towards the target. Unfortunately, he has left 2 solid 10 pins in the first 2 frames.
Third at the Quaker State this year, 4th at the AC Delco Classic, which began our tour in January.
Very noticeable orange object on the index finger of Justin Hromek, and actually just helps him grip the ball a little better and keeps him from getting a blister. He balances or keys off his index finger. A lot of players use the index finger as the center of their balance. He's one of those players. It's a good idea, and he probably gets a little better grip on the ball. He's throwing 2 excellent shots to start the match, and nothing good has happened. Four 7, pretty good first 3 frames on a demanding condition tournament leader. Ball cuts through, the 2 pin goes to sideboard, doesn't quite get enough impetus out of the flat gutter to knock out the 4 and 7s. Cross lane spare, he will trail by 13 with a conversion.
All right. 3 spares while his opponent has a double working, shooting in the third frame.
Parker has never won a Triple Crown event. He came within 1 ball last year at the General Tire Tournament of Champions when he left the 6 pin to lose to George Branham III.
A 6 pin. Great conduct. 4 in a row. This man could win it too.
Confident look on Justin Romick's face. And rightfully so.
Four frames, 3 strikes. Motown music. We're in their area. We're in Troy, Michigan. We will return.
Where nature stores gas, where man does. Right idea. Brighter idea.
True value. Help is just around the corner.
I don't need some fancy cologne to tell me I'm a man. I use Skin Bracer. It smells great. But it also cools and tones my skin. Confidence is very sexy. Don't you think?
Skin Bracer Aftershave.
By Menon.
Okay, I confess. I want my hair to look great. So I use a special shampoo and conditioner that cleans and completely conditions without the hassle. Net result, no matter what I've been doing, my hair does what I want it to.
Burt Plus. Great hair. No fuss.
Our country's greatest stars take on our reigning national champions in a special competition. It's the Hershey's Kisses Pro-Am Skating Championship Sunday here on ABC.
While we were away, Justin Hromek, a double strike in the fourth and fifth, and Parker Bohn III just the strike in the fifth frame, giving him a double in the championship match, $46,000. To the winner, more important is the title. But I can't make light of the difference between being first and second, $22,000.
And for Justin Hromek, a trip to the General Tire Tournament of Champions 2 weeks from now and a three-year exemption. Parker Bohn already secured into the tournament with many victories.
How about this game Romek's bowled? He's a little bit apprehensive because he hasn't been there before and he wants to prove himself. But solid 10, a 4-7, then shreds the rack in the fourth, fifth, and sixth frames. And he's letting Parker Bohn know he's out there to win the tournament. Here's a man who can bench press 280 pounds, and he's got a 16-pound spheroid in his hand, and this is where he wants to roll it. He can cut the lead to two pins right now with another strike.
Hello. Showed himself a top seed with a 236 to 234 win over Eric Forkel, this graduate of Wichita State, bowling champion there as well.
Bohn has not faced an opponent like this today. Everybody else struggled. They averaged a mere 187 against him. All of a sudden, Hromek throws four in a row. Parker has risen to the occasion. Right now, he sees a problem with the foul light or foul line. He's talking to Frank Esposito and tournament director Johnny Campos.
Looking on Kevin Shippey.
The foul light is on, okay. Basically, if it went on, Chris, they should have had a foul ruling on the last attempt. That would have been Justin Hromek in the sixth frame. Ooh. Somebody should have noticed it and made a ruling about a foul. Because anytime you make a shot, regardless of where it is, if the foul light goes on in the area of your shot, they need to make a ruling.
Could it be a malfunction?
Obviously it is, because we could see that he didn't come close to the foul line, but they should make a ruling.
All right.
And I guess Johnny Campos, tournament director, says that it was not even close. They weren't aware because of the tremendous lighting we have in this building that the foul light was even on. So it's been deemed not a foul. The match will continue.
We'll have to get our 5,000-watt strobe lights that are on the pace car. That get their attention, wouldn't it?
You look good driving that thing.
Well, who wouldn't?
See how this affects the match. This is the U.S. Open Championship, the second jewel in bowling's triple crown. Parker Bohn with a mere two-pin lead, three strikes in a row, working seventh frame. Parker Bohn continues to lead by 12.
Now, because of the malfunction, Jason Couch, fine professional bowler, is the live judge standing.
The solid eight. The ball doesn't respect these 3-pound, 8-ounce pins as Parker Bohn throws a tremendous shot down there. And now, if he spares, he'll lead by 11. The irony of a foul judge, that means that he will call it regardless of whether the lights go on, is that the original U.S. Open or national match game was the user of foul judges 40 years ago.
Being a bad breaks, two of our people we know, journalist Herb Tam, father of our director Larry, hospitalized on the West Coast pneumonia. Now, Herb, pay attention to those nurses.
And get well wishes from all of us to your son, Ted Schenkel, who's at Goshen Indian Hospital recovering. We hope to see him out in a few days, and best to him.
Thank you, Bo.
You bet.
Oh, they're bowling in this championship game. Tremendous.
Well, if there was any doubt in anybody's mind of how good Justin Hromek is out here on the tour, he leads the tour in consecutive caches with 15. He's not a household name, but he has proven himself through 8 frames. Can he slam the door on one of the great ones out here, Parker Bohn, for his first title? 2 frames from now, we'll know the answer.
Look at that, string them 6 in a row. With the same intensity, our live judge, Jason Couch, he's taking his work very seriously, Nisha.
Well, you'd hate to see a tournament, as we look at Jason Couch, the foul judge, determined by a malfunction. Now it's up for Parker Bohn to answer the call. Parker with a little extra speed. He got a bad break in the 8th frame where he left a solid 8. Zips it out there. Pretty good shot. Doesn't quite pop out the 7 here in the 9th. It's going down to the 10th frame for all the money.
Looking for his first major, Parker Bohn. Stressful afternoon. He had 3 victories coming into this championship game. He has 10 titles in 10 years, a member of the PBA.
Parker Bohn, a potential 247. He cannot shut out Hromek, who's going at a 247 pace and a possible 267. Final game, United States Open. Parker Bohn bowled 9 tremendous frames and has just let that ball slip through his hand right here in the 10th. He has not by any means secured a victory for his opponent, but he, as you see the ball sliding by, doesn't quite catch the lift. He's the 3, 5, 6, 9, 10. Converts it, he's still in. Parker with a full count would be 232. You see the ball impacting the 3 and 5. Gets a good kick off the sideboard with a 3-pin, taking out the 9. 232. He still makes Justin Hromek throw a good shot in the 10th for his first championship.
Parker did a terrific job in those victories over some tough opponents. Jess Stayrook, Brian Voss, Eric Forkel.
How big is this shot? Never won before. Needs 8 pins on his first ball to become the first player I've ever seen to be the national junior champion, the collegiate champion, and now the pro champion. Here we go.
He's done it.
Wichita State. Justin Hromek from Andover, Kansas. United States Open champion, 46,000. We'll be back.
Hurry, girls, before Daddy gets up. Ooh, ready.
Now, no more of these. They're Daddy's corn pops.
Oh, look. Daddy's bowl is too full.
The problem with a cereal that tastes like popcorn, only sweeter, is that it disappears like popcorn, only faster.
Mommy, that's Daddy.
Who's there?
Hi, girls.
Happy birthday.
Now, let's all go make him breakfast.
Kellogg's Corn Pops. It's hard to stop when it's Pops.
You know, winning never gets old. And neither does saving money. If you're 50 or over, just call 1-800-4-CHOICE to reserve a room in any Quality, Comfort, Clarion, or Sleep hotel. And you can save 30% off the price of your room. That number again, 1-800-4-CHOICE. Perfect.
Travelers 50 and over save 30% at Quality, Comfort, Clarion, and Sleep hotel.
As the thermometer drops, dangerous crystals can form in your car's engine, threatening to shorten its life. That's why today's Quaker State has engineered intelligent oil. Oil that senses the changing threats in your engine and adapts its own molecular structure for continuous protection. So whenever the driving conditions change, so does Quaker State. The intelligent oil for longer engine life.
A very expensive maker of lawn tractors likes to say, nothing runs like them. The makers of Yardman tractors take exception to that. The Yardman lawn tractor uses a powerful engine to mulch, bag, and side discharge, and it has a hydrostatic transmission. So it runs like a you-know-what, only it doesn't run for nearly as much money. Yardman. American-made, American-owned.
And there's the U.S. Open prize money. $46,000 to Justin Hromek. He is the champion. Bill Strike, John Laspina, and Bill Blue are there with a very happy 27-year-older from Andover, Kansas. We'll see you next week from Markham, Ontario, Canada. For Bo Burton, I'm Chris Schenkel. Goodbye.
The Pro Bowlers Tour has been brought to you by Quaker State, the intelligent oil for longer engine life. Kellogg's, with good taste, nutrition, and value, the best to you each morning from Kellogg's. And True Value, help is just around the corner. Coming up next on ABC's Wide World of Sports, the Harlem Globetrotters bring their special magic to Walt Disney World. And from high above the rim, it's the final of the Foot Locker Slam Fest.